Oh my god, what happened? I don't know what happened. Last thing I remember, I finished my worst movies of the 2010s. And then I fell down. Now I'm in my bed. And I'm wearing different clothes. What day is it? It's already February. That means the Oscars have passed already. Alexa, who won Best Picture at the 2020 Oscars?
This might answer your question. The winner of the 2020 Oscar for Best Motion Picture of the Year is Parasite.
Oh, dang it. Jojo Rabbit didn't win. Alexa, what did Jojo Rabbit win at the Oscars?
Jojo Rabbit has won one Oscar out of the six nominations it has received. Winning categories include Best Adapted Screenplay.
Okay. Alright. Man. After reviewing so much terrible movies, like Birdemic, The Last Airbender, The Talking Cat, Terminator Genesis, Fant Four Stick, Cool Cat Saves the Kids, and Batman v Superman, my god, so many pretty bad movies. But now, I can finally, I can now go over the best movies from the decade. Alright. Let me get up. Alright. Just gotta get ready.
Oh, by the way, I got Netflix, and I finally saw The Irishman. Alright, so, the best movies of 2010 is...
Girlfriend.
There's this girl that really likes me a lot, but I don't know if I want to, you know, get involved.
Well, don't get her pregnant, that's all.
Inception, I love this movie. It's it has so much ideas and it's really deep, and just the acting and the characters that Christopher Nolan writes, and I'm definitely a huge fan of Christopher Nolan. I'm excited for Tenet, even though I don't know that much about it, but it looks really good, and I just like the visuals and the cinematography and the sound mix, and they all got... And they all won for best at the Academy. Even though Hans Zimmer was definitely snubbed for original song or score. But Inception is so great. I gotta ask, where did Joseph Gordon-Levitt go? Why don't we see him in big budget action movies anymore? I don't get that. And also Ellen Page, who I don't even where is she? The last movie I think she was in was Days of Future Past. But Leonardo DiCaprio, Tom Hardy, Ken Watanabe, just great. Inception, definitely one of the best movies of the decade. And so the next film, boy, I saw this movie the day I saw Jojo Rabbit. This is a very like a movie that could be maybe a little disturbing for some people, but it's really that Taika's humor to make something that looks like that would be very like disturbing or like, you know, sad, but he makes it funny, and that's why I think he's one of the most unique comedians or comedic directors living today, and I hope he goes down in history as one of them. But I just love the story about this boy trying to cope with bond with his dad, and just like how it's a very small movie with like in this quirky environment, because I think a lot of people would compare Wes Anderson and Taika Waititi sometimes. I mean, like at times, like Taika can use Anderson's visual style, like in Jojo Rabbit. I've heard a lot of complaints about that, but yeah, I love boy. It is definitely one of his best movies, and. And yeah, it's definitely one of the best movies of the decade. It's just a funny little independent comedy. And so, on to 2011. Yes, I do have, there are Marvel movies on this list, and, X-Men First Class is definitely one of them. This was my first X-Men movie I ever saw, and I loved it, and I don't love it as much as I used to, but I still think it's a good movie. Definitely the best out of the X-Men movies. The thing I do like is that it's really the acting from Michael Fassbender, James McAvoy, and Jennifer Lawrence and Rose Bryce and Kevin Bacon. There are some stuff that is a little corny on that. Definitely the effects have not aged well. And even a lot of people complain about Emma Frost, but I didn't really care. I think she was the actress did fine. And I think the visual effects on her were all right, but yeah, the effects aren't that good, and also a little bit of the editing. But the action and just the acting and the character development, I think, is really good. And I think Kevin Bacon is such a like evil villain that you just like love to hate. And just how I think it's definitely one of the few best prequels. So that's X-Men First Class. And it's one of my favorite Marvel movies from the decade. So, next movie is Rango. A lot of people maybe forgot about this. It's a Johnny Depp movie, and he's this chameleon who, he gets lost in the desert, and he, like, kind of, and it's this animated western, and I think it's very different from a lot of animated movies, and it's very rare, I don't know if it won best animated feature. But it's very good and very different. If you don't like all these sappy Disney movies, then definitely go check this one out. This is a very good animated movie, because it's just a very dirty, and the designs are, my God, the designs are incredible on these characters. And has the same director of the Pirates of the Caribbean. And Rango. I think it's a very good animated movie. It's not the only animated movie on this list. I have other animated movies coming along, but on to the best movies of 2012.
Hold your breath and count to 10. Feel the earth move.
So for the background of my iPad, I have a picture for the gun barrel scene in Skyfall. I've only seen like 7 or 8 Bond movies, because I've seen all the Daniel Craig besides the new one that's coming out. I've seen almost all the Connerys. I've seen like the first 50 minutes of GoldenEye, and the same for On Her Majesty's Secret Service. And definitely my favorite one out of all of them, I won't say that it's the best, but Skyfall and From Russia with Love, I think they are one of the best ones out of the ones I've seen. The thing I like about Skyfall is that Sam Mendes doesn't really make the plot very hard to follow, because I found Casino Royale or Quantum of Solace, their plots to be hard to follow. But in this, it's kind of a simple plot. It's just about a rogue agent who wants to get revenge on MI6, and he wants to kill M, and James Bond has to protect her from it. And not that I don't like hard plots to follow, or I think simple plots are bad, but I just it kind of makes Bond more. This one is definitely a very popcorn movie to watch, and definitely Sam Mendes and Roger Deakins definitely work great together with this movie and 1917. And also, Roger Deakins, actually, I forgot to mention, he did do Rango. But again, I enjoy Skyfall. It's a very fun Bond movie. And definitely how it changes the formula. And it kind of shows how that Casino Royale wasn't just one fluke. That Bond is still good, and Bond can still be great. I mean, even though, whatever your thoughts on Spectre, even Spectre, I think, is actually a good movie. But we'll see how this franchise of Daniel Craig movies will end with No Time to Die. But anyway, Skyfall is a great movie with great acting from Daniel Craig, Judi Dench, and Javier Bardem. So on to the next movie, Moonrise Kingdom. So I'm definitely excited for the next Wes Anderson movie, The French Dispatch. I wanted to see The Isle of Dogs in the theater, but my parents didn't want to see it because all the dogs were like ugly, I guess. But Moonrise Kingdom is definitely I like to watch it mostly because since I'm in the Boy Scouts, and at the end it definitely reminds me of the times I go camping towards the third act of the film. But it's just such like how Wes Anderson makes these quirky comedies, and how they're all about people's like troubled, how they're about people like that are very troubled and socially, and it's this time it's on kids, on how kids are just these kids that run away just to from their parents or foster parents to go to this just area where like they can rule, and it's just this coming of age story about young love and just how life is just a very difficult, but I still very enjoying this movie. The cinematography is really, really good for Wes Anderson. I don't know if he's ever been nominated or if any of his movies have been nominated or won any Oscars. I'm not sure about that. But still, Moonrise Kingdom is very good, and it's just a very like quirky comedy just on, again, on young love and just how people struggling. Definitely this is like, I think this is like the last good Bruce Willis movie, because he's really, really good in this movie, even though now he just makes bad movies. And there's also good performances from Edward Norton, Bill Murray, and Frances McDormand, and also a very young Lucas Hedgenson, I hope I'm saying his name right, from Manchester by the Sea, and Lady Bird. But yeah, this is a very good movie. I highly recommend you watch Moonrise Kingdom. So on to the best movies of 2013.
Joe, what are we gonna tell our parents?
My name is Jamal Colorado, and I have kidnapped your son.
Anfernee, Texas?
Deshaun, Utah.
Yeah, I decided on the format of Denzel Washington, a black first name followed by a state.
Good effort, although savagely racist.
So I only picked one movie for 2013 because I don't really think 2013 was the best year for movies. So I picked The Kings of Summer, which is an independent teen comedy with Ron Swanson and Tammy. They're in it, but they're not a couple in this one, even though they're actually married in real life. But it's about these two kids. One of them is the kid from Jurassic Park, and they go off into the woods because they don't like their parents, and so they go off. They run away from home with this weird kid named Biagio, and they build a house, and they live there for their entire summer. And it's this coming of age story, and I really like it just because of how it's just this story of brotherhood and family, and what it means to just want, and I mean like how friendships. And just how, like, they both like this one girl, and they like, kind of grow apart from each other. I think it's very deep, like, at times. Just about how they're learning how to mature and stuff, and just, I really like this movie. I definitely recommend it, but the best part is really the comedy and, like, the witty comebacks, mostly from Nick Offerman. Like, when he's with, like, when we're, like, with the adults and the police officers and the, and, like, his daughter and his boyfriend and her boyfriend. That stuff is really good. It's just a really, like, good comedy. And I definitely, like, it's definitely worth checking out. So, yeah, it's a nice little indie movie. And that's the best for 2013. So, on to 2014. Guardians of the Galaxy was the first Marvel movie I saw in the theater, and I didn't like it. Like, I didn't think it was that great when I first saw it. But then last year when I was rewatching Marvel movies for Endgame, I loved it. It's a comedy, and it's also this superhero comic book movie, but it really feels like a comedy in my opinion. And that's because of James Gunn and the acting from mostly Chris Pratt and Bradley Cooper. And the writing is mostly provided for, Dave Bautista and Zoe Zendaya and Vin Diesel. And it just comes together so good. And a lot of people thought it wouldn't be that good. And it turned out it was a really good gamble. And the thing is, it is the comedy and the acting, but it's really the characters that are written. They're not like these perfect superhero nice guys. They're these awful people. They're like outcasts or like thieves, and they just don't have honor and stuff. And that's what really separates them from Iron Man and Captain America. And they're just reckless. That's what I like about them, is that they're not perfect, and they have these flaws, and they all just come together to save the galaxy, and that's what I really like about Guardians of the Galaxy, and it's just very fun. I have fun watching it all the time, and Guardians of the Galaxy might be my favorite Marvel movie. So next movie is the Lego Movie. This is my favorite animated movie, and that's also because of Phil Lord and Chris Miller. I think are like they're the Coen brothers of animation. Just how the movie's animated, and also has to do with the great comedy, with just how it's so much like with the editing and the writing. That's what makes it funny, and the voice acting from Chris Pratt and Will Ferrell and Elizabeth Banks and Nick Offerman. And then you got people that are not really funny, or like you would not expect them to have that much charisma, and Liam Neeson and Morgan Freeman. My God, they like steal the show, almost. And it really taught me that movies could actually have like a message, or like symbolism, and how movies can actually be deep, and they could have morals. And I thought that was pretty breakthrough, for me. And yeah, Lego Movie, my favorite animated movie of all time, and just what could have been one big product placement commercial, turned out to be this heartwarming film, and that has actually, like, has some care into it. And so, that's why Lego Movie and Guardians of the Galaxy are no doubtably the best movies of the decade. So, that's it for part one, so, part two will come. No, I'm not going to fake anything. Alright, subscribe, and I'll see you next time to finish off the best movies of the decade.